everybody. This is Magnum Pie. I'm here with Teku, Golgotha, and Dark Templar. Vahilo's on his way. At least that's what he tells us. But we're going to kick off without him here. We're Initiative Zero, and we're glad you're here with us. This is Rifts, the Face of Evil. And we are going to continue with this nostalgic first adventure that was published by Palladium Books. We're kind of on a bit of a sidetrack, but it's kind of cool. If you like what you've been hearing and you haven't subscribed yet, hit the subscribe button. If you want to be notified, hit the bell for notifications. And leave us comments down below. We love hearing from you guys. We always respond if we can. And I haven't had a chance when I haven't been able to respond yet, I don't think. So please, down below. We've got the links to these books and... we'd love to hear from you. How's Teku, Golgi, and DT doing?
Oh, the weather's fucking improved. That's good.
Thank you for the comments, guys. Thank you for the comments. Really appreciate it.
Yep.
I'm glad that someone did not see that coming, because neither did anyone else besides myself.
Yeah, no kidding. Jesus Christ.
That's fantastic.
We appreciate the support. We appreciate the... the more critical comment. It's been a good go.
I accept all criticisms. It's fantastic.
Oh. Yeah, it's good times.
It has made our life much more difficult, but that's okay. We will persevere.
The comments or sure. DT?
Yes. Either way.
Okay. Cool. Yeah. No, it's great to actually. You know, when we started this, we were just like, we have so much fun with this. We should just throw up our episodes and let people laugh too. And I don't know, we just kind of did it like that. We never really planned on it being anything really amazing or anything like that. Just something for fun. And we're just so happy that we've now have 200 subscribers, hundreds of people watching us. We're so happy to have everybody.
Going on the resume.
There you go. Cool. All right. Well, so when we last left, we had Portland walking into the woods, and he had his poncho on, and he was basically leaving the town site because of coalition concerns. Senate, Sir Luke, and Old Jack, you guys were in the boarding house, and you're looking out the window and you see two coalition grunts with jetpacks on landing in the street, because there's still the chaos in front of the bar, and there's a couple of sky cycles also fly in, and two guys dismount their sky cycles. That was two episodes ago, because the last episode was Lex's big battle with the dog pack, and you guys played some NPCs. But we're going to jump back to the town and to Portland in the woods. So I think what we're going to do is start with Portland in the woods. So Portland, you are walking in the woods. Got a poncho on. The commotion of the town site slowly becoming quieter and quieter behind you, as the sound of you stepping on twigs and the like making your way through the cold forest. Now it is again the beginning of November, so the leaves are off the trees, and you're kind of walking through the woods there.
All right. So I'm not necessarily, I don't know where like their base is or anything like that, or like really any geography in this forest per se. So I'm just gonna try to get a little more deeper into the forest, so that I just don't even want to be like close enough to the edge of it that I can even be spotted by anyone. Does that make sense?
Yeah, that makes sense. Yeah, you want to just kind of go deep, right?
Exactly.
Cool. All right. So you're stepping through, and pretty well trying to.
Now, can I? Oh, sorry. Go ahead.
Continue. Oh, I was just gonna say, you're pretty well trying to stay on a straight path as best you can. It's really actually hard to do. People will often start making arcs and stuff as they will try to attempt to walk in a straight line. If you have land navigation or navigation at this point, since it's dark outside, you might be able to to do that, to maintain a straight course if you want. But if you don't really care if you're taking a straight course, you can just keep walking.
No, I'll take a straight course. I have land navigation here.
Okay. It's pretty dark, and I would say you weren't familiar with the lay of the land to begin with. And now that it's dark, you're probably even less familiar. Do you have a night vision spell or anything like that?
I swear, as I was walking in here, I was trying to find it.
I think the only person that had night vision was Senate.
But I can, like...
I thought you could make a little bauble of light or something.
Oh, I have a globe of daylight that I can use. I said yeah. that.
Yeah, it'll I'm light up about 10 feet or so. Yeah.
But that's a good way to get spotted if you're looking.
That's right. Yeah, that's right.
Yeah, I'm not using that. No, I'm not using that. There doesn't have to be a giant ley line laying around, is there?
No, they. So just to give you a general lay of the land, because you guys are kind of from here. So to the west of, again, to the west of Unity, is the town of New Hope. Both Unity and New Hope are human supremacist. Okay, Unity got the Coalition outpost, right? They kind of got a deal there. But to the west of Unity is New Hope. And then to the west of New Hope is a little stretch of land before the magic density starts to increase again as you get closer to Laszlo, which is what is in our day and age Toronto. But as you get closer to that, the magic density really kicks up. The reason why Unity and New Hope exist where they do is because of the lack of magic energy, right? They found a place where there weren't rifts opening up all the time and the monsters were coming out, right? Because they're afraid of those things and they want to stay away from them. So they've settled here for that reason. So yeah, you're not going to find a lot of ley lines or nexus points here. Go west a ways, you'll find some. But it's like a town and then some wilderness over to the west.
So yeah, I'll use my land navigation because I want to use a ball right now.
Okay, so I would say your lack of familiarity, you're just kind of blazing a trail into the woods, in unfamiliar woods, and the fact that it's dark, I'm going to give you minus 20% on your land navigation.
Sounds good.
Yeah, you're just trying to maintain a straight line, right?
So that you can find a way back. So in the situation modifier, just put 20 then?
Minus 20, yep.
Minus 20 there. Minus
20. Submit. Yep, so you're doing your best to continue forward. You think you're going straight, but you're actually kind of veering off a little ways. And let's see, high roll, well, you'll say you're veering right. Low roll, you are veering left. Okay, so you're veering right. There you go. But not that you know that.
Do I have a walkie-talkie? Like, did they bring a walkie-talkie? I'm not even sure. Do I have a walkie-talkie on me?
It would be in your equipment.
I don't think we did.
Yeah, the only...
like, the armor pieces.
That's right. It's built into the environmental armor. But unless you have a radio on you, it would be in your equipment. I don't think you have a radio.
Well, cool. In that case, I will just continue walking.
Okay, cool. Give me a perception check here.
Oh, I just lost my thing. Perception.
Right under horror factor, sure. ISP, PP. All right. So you're walking along, you are immediately from your right, you hear a gruff voice saying, "Freeze, don't move."
Oh, you poor dog.
And when you look to your right, where the voice is coming from, you see a small Lakeland Terrier with a CS-18 laser pistol pointed at you.
Okay.
And hands where I can see him. He says, he looks a little rattled. He looks, yeah. Okay. He looks like, he looks jumpy, right? His tail is not wagging, right? It's you know, and he's, yeah, he's looking a little shaky.
He doesn't feel like a good boy.
Is no. Is he seeing me from the back?
From the side.
Or like, from the side, okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Sounds good.
And again, you're not wearing your Leyline Walker garb. You didn't put that back right. on. You did put on
right.
The rain poncho. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So I'm going to put my hands up.
All right.
And freeze. Now, I have a question. When I do magic, do I have to use my hands to do it?
There is a casting. Yeah. It's not a psychic power. So you have to make gestures and say words and all that stuff.
Okay. Sounds good.
Yep. All right. And
is there a problem?
Yeah. Yeah, there is.
Oh.
You can use magic.
Okay. You got that from my poncho?
No. I can smell you.
It's a little racist.
No.
Okay.
Where are you going?
Into the forest? Where are you going?
Out of the forest. Heading back to the...
That way.
Heading back... To the outpost.
And
you're coming with me. And he kind of motions with the pistol for you to turn and walk back in the direction you came from.
All right. I am going to use... Sorry, one second here. Oh. Are you wondering, my charismatic aura here or my fear?
Okay, if you're going to try to do something, we're going to have to roll for initiative.
You probably want to put up your armor.
Probably. But, you know. We all live pretty loose, don't we?
Okay.
All right. Yeah, anyways. Yeah, I guess I will put up my armor.
Okay, so we're going to have to roll initiative.
Yeah. Sounds good. Initiative.
Make sure you select your token.
Oh, yeah, you're right. I did not do that. Initiative. These low rolls are amazing.
Awesome. All right. So you put your hand there, and the initiative is basically to see who goes first, right? So your intention is to cast a spell, from what I was gathering there. And so you begin to do you begin to move your hands, and he's like, keep your hands where I can see them, or I'll blast you in half.
Yeah, my turn is to make the armor, right? That was his turn?
He says that. So he's got the gun trained on you. So he's essentially taking aim on you. Yeah.
So you're taking aim and he's talking?
You can always, like, you can just a small blurb like that doesn't use your action. Just like movement doesn't use your action. Yeah. If you carry on a conversation, then we're going to use up your time. But he literally said as he kept, you know, keep your hands where I can see him or I'll blast you in half. That took me about 3 seconds to say, right? So.
Sure.
Yeah.
Okay.
You're on.
Yeah, I cast the armor of Ithan.
Okay. So you cast the spell, take the points off.
Mm-hmm.
And we'll make sure you've got your armor showing there. All right. And on his attack, he will fire.
Do I get a dodge or no?
It would be really difficult for you to dodge, but you can try to dodge if you want. You know it's there. You know it's coming. I'm assuming that you kind of... Did you turn to face him when you cast the spell, or did you keep him to your back?
I kept him to my back when I did it.
Yeah, so... then you wouldn't be able to dodge because you can't necessarily see that he's going to shoot.
Okay.
Yeah. So he will fire. One is an automatic miss. I'm going to say that it's a misfire. Like the gun, for some reason, doesn't fire. Actually, what I will say is that he's actually out. He shot enough during the firefight that happened last time that he needs to reload his clip. And you can hear him say, "Oh no, you're on, Portland."
Oh yes.
Oh yeah!
I can't believe you missed the clip. Oh, yeah. It was there.
Yeah.
All right.
It was there.
Portland turns into the Kool-Aid man. All right.
Okay. Was this one still wearing armor? I can't remember. This one
yeah, wearing he's armor. Wearing armor, like similar to what you can see in the picture of him.
Okay, there. I wasn't sure whether he got blasted off or not.
No.
So, fair enough. Okay, well, I don't want him to move because kind of a thing. But, he has... The main... Okay, I am going to Carpet of Adhesion.
Okay, he's still behind you, dude, so I just need to understand. You're turning around and casting a spell? That's the...
Right.
Okay, cool. So you turn, spin around, maybe take a couple steps back, and Carpet of Adhesion him.
Yes.
All right.
Do I need to roll for this?
No, he needs to roll for it. You just need to take your...
Oh, I will.
All right, and he doesn't have a bonus, so here we go. I think he saves. So you roll 2d6, I believe, and that's the number of minutes he's stuck there or something like that.
Yeah.
Is it 2d6?
Even though he succeed, I still... Oh, 1 second here. Nope, wrong one. It is...
So if he saves, he's still stuck?
Yeah.
Yes.
Oh, that's handy.
Yeah, it is... Where is it? Why can't I read it? Oh, saving throw. Yeah, two-sided
dice. Two six-sided dice. Yeah. So 2d6, and that's how many rounds. Okay, not minutes. Good. That makes more sense. Okay, so 5. I'm just going to put a marker on him. Cool. 5 rounds. So you do that, and he's stuck, and you're not super far away from him, but you're far away. I'd imagine you're far enough away that he can't reach you, right? So he quickly releases the clip in his pistol and swaps it for one on his belt and slaps the clip in, so he reloads. Your turn.
Okay. 1 second. Okay, I befuddle.
All right. What's the saving throw on befuddle?
Saving throw. Successful save versus magic.
Just standard. Okay. Cool. And I believe you have a spell strength. Spell strength is 13, so your save to for people to save against your magic, they have to roll over a 13. Okay. So you cast Befuddle. And he does not save. So you now have yourself a befuddled, stuck, very confused dog boy.
Yep, I do.
All right, and that means he's minus 2 to strike, parry, and dodge. All of his attacks per melee are reduced by half. And, yeah, he is not... he is just out of it, pretty much. And so that would mean, we'll say he loses his last attack then. Your last attack?
My last attack?
Yep, for this round.
Oh, wait, sorry. I am going to... Ooh, what can I really do to this guy? I could literally send a cannonball at this guy, can't I?
You could. You'd damage the armor. He does have portions of his body that are not armored, as you can tell in the picture, right? Arms, his legs only...
Portland's calling card.
Yeah, his legs only have shin guards. His arms have vambrances on the forearms. His face is not armored, but he does have a kind of a skull cap armor, but it's mostly his main body that's armored.
Oh, so I just... Well, listening to super accurate, I can just aim at his head then. Just blow off his head.
You can aim strike, yeah. But when they say super accurate, it still means... It doesn't mean you don't have to roll. You still have to make a roll, and you still would have to take aim. But you could spend 3 actions doing an aimed called shot. And I think it gives you normally a +2 bonus to strike in addition to the +2 you would get from an aimed shot. So that would be a +4 bonus. To strike the head, you're at -4. So it would be a straight roll.
I see.
But if you hit him in the head, you're gonna kill him, right? Like, flat out.
True. I am gonna kill him.
Now, he does, if you look at him, he does have a vibroblade sheathed on his leg. He has that gun in his hand. So...
Yeah. So if I were to use the magic net on him, would it put him into a prone position, like crouched down if the net goes on him?
No, he's just kind of stuck. You know, he's basically going to struggle to get the net off because it's a magic energy net. It doesn't have any weight.
Okay. Well, you know what? I'm going to put the fear of God into this guy. I think that's what I'm going to do.
Okay. Cool.
Yeah.
So this is your last attack. Fear. You're going to use fear. All right.
Yeah. Horror factor 16.
Yeah. So he just makes a save versus horror factor then.
Oh, wait. That only... Wait. Sorry. Whoa. The room is suddenly washed with terror and momentarily stunned. Oh, it's only momentarily stunned.
Yeah. It will... He'll lose an attack if he fails, which means he'll only get one attack the next round.
Oh, I see.
And this you'll still have attacks. 4. Well, yeah, you'll still have 4. So.
Okay. All right. Sounds good. I will, I'll use the fear just so I can knock down one of his attacks. I'll use that.
Yeah. His eyes get really, like, he's confused. His eyes get really wide. And you can see he tries to take a step back, but his feet are stuck. And, he kind of looks around. Super scared, and he will lose initiative, and his first melee attack, and he can't defend against your first strike in the round. So now we roll initiative again, and he gets a 0, right. So he goes last.
Do I want me to roll still or no?
Yeah, just for completeness, in case somebody else enters into the combat. We'll know what the ranking is.
Okay, sounds good. As soon as I find it again.
Oh,
How do I roll a 2, a 3, and a 2? What is going on?
I think the, I don't know, my assessment would be that you suck. I think that's kind of how it goes.
But... yeah, no kidding.
Yeah.
Dang. Brutal. All right, well, since I go first, since I can say something and do something at the same time,
yep.
I'm going to say, I'm going to kill you now, and I'm going to throw a stone at him.
Okay, you cast the stone, you're aiming for his head?
No, I think I'm going to, well, he has what, body armor, you said?
Yeah, the armor could come in useful for Lex if you find Lex, right? Lex could wear that armor.
Right, right. Yeah, you know what? I will do a called shot, or I'll try to aim. I can't speak. Sorry, audience. I am going to. Is it called shot? Is that what I'm saying? To
focus on his head. Yeah, I would do a called aimed shot. So it's gonna
call.
You're gonna cast the spell. That creates the ball. Then you're gonna do a called aimed shot, which is three more attacks. So on your last attack this round, you will lob that at him.
Yes.
Yeah, and. His first, he loses his first attack after you cast, right? Because he's scared, and he loses half of his remaining attacks. He only has one attack left. You you hold the ball. You start kind of lining up his head as you wind back, and he quickly reaches down and grabs his radio off his belt with his hand, like shaking and stuff like that. But basically his action is to basically unsnap it from his belt and grab it. And, but he's fumbling, like he's so befuddled. He's trying to figure out how to use it. That's why he doesn't have any other attacks this round. So your next attack is basically aiming, and your last attack is when you get to roll to blast his head to smithereens.
Yes. Sounds good.
With a +4. Minus four, so a +0 is what you got. Just straight roll.
Just a one.
Straight roll. If you get an 8 or higher, you've hit him in the head.
Wait, I'm rolling right now. I want to pray for myself.
Boom.
Oh my gosh.
And you
that
remove...
That 5 almost rolled. I was like, oh my gosh, that 5.
Yeah, you splat his head. His body drops to the ground. It's shivering, and there's blood all over the place. You hear the clank of the MDC helmet that basically has flown from whatever's left of his head. He just drops onto the carpet of adhesion and is jiggling. Right, the remaining nerve endings are firing, and you have taken care of business there. You can cancel. Yeah. You can cancel your carpet of adhesion if you want to.
I will after he stops wiggling and jiggling, I will cancel that and then start to remove the armor from this whatever this is left of this thing.
Yeah.
Body.
Yeah, for sure. And
then if I can find any scraps of that helmet, I'll probably grab that too if it's not too damaged.
Yeah, you can probably find the helmet. You just follow the trail of splat as it goes along, and you'll be able to pick up the helmet for sure. He also has
a radio.
He has a short range radio, yeah, and he has an SDC submachine gun, fist spikes, fragmentation grenade, C-18 laser pistol.
Holy shit! Holy fuck.
He has a vibro saber as well as a conventional knife, and the armor. Yeah,
saber like a sword saber.
Like a short sword, a vibro short sword, yeah.
Oh, that hurts, Sir Luke. I'm just curious. Does that hurt? Does that hurt?
Why would it hurt? I've got my own. I could make mine appear.
Sorry, I don't mean Sir Luke. I mean Golgotha, just in particular. That's
what? Okay. I mean, Golgotha.
It's okay. Stop.
I personally don't use, I like bludgeoning weapons myself, but, you know.
Sure you do. Anyways. So, I will take that. Does he have a backpack on?
Just curious. No, backpack. That's what he's got. Okay. I listed everything that he's got there. Yeah.
All right, I'll take a shit.
All right. And and you've also you launched that ball and it carries through. It probably knocked a hole through or knocked chunks of wood off. Like you could hear some wood splatter or splintering off in the distance as you fired that MDC cannonball. We'll jump to Lex because Vahilo is here.
Vahilo! Hey!
There he is.
Hi, everybody.
When we last left your character, you were in the woods killing a bunch of dog boys. And you and Sly, right?
Yep. Yeah, Sly and I and Rasputin was somewhere getting...
getting armored up, yeah.
Jam their radios and all that kind of stuff, but I don't think he got into the fight.
Yeah, so what's your plan now? There was one dog boy that got away.
And... Yeah, so I want to go in and get see if there's any remaining armor from some of the other dog boys that I can suit myself up in. I know the armor that I had got decimated off me.
That's right. Yeah, there was a suit. There was a suit that was intact that you could take.
Yeah.
So you switch your armor out.
Helmets that fit and that kind of stuff.
Yeah, you can switch your armor out for sure.
Get a walkie-talkie and kind of play the role of a dog boy pack with good old Sly there.
All right. Sounds good. And
I think we'd start to make our way back to the weapons cache in that base.
Okay, so you're making your way back in the direction of town then.
Yeah.
Okay. Cool. Sly is still tinkering with his radio, and he's like, "I've got to make sure that I can keep their radio signals blocked. We still haven't seen a Psy Stalker, right?" And he keeps tinkering with the radio. He's kind of wearing the backpack backwards so that he can, you know, have it in front of him. And let me just roll for his radio countermeasures here. It says, I think I got it, but I won't be able to tell. I sure hope they don't have a comms guy. He'll figure out I'm blocking their signal like tomorrow. Nobody's business. So, you guys...
I think even if we're not blocking their signal, I mean, we can play the role of a dog boy pack, can't we? I mean, we're smaller in numbers, but we got separated, something happened.
I don't have the right armor, though.
Well, do you think we can find some? We gotta find a Psy Stalker.
Yeah, I could be your prisoner.
All that works too. I mean, they probably heard all the commotion of something going on. Well, let's slowly make our way to that weapons cache, and you know, if it so happens that we come across a group with a Psy Stalker, we can see what we can do.
All right. So you guys walk for a little bit. Are you trying to prowl as you walk, or are you just walking?
I think we're just walking.
Okay, cool. So you just walk along, I mean, and...
We can try to prowl, like maybe just we're staying along the tree line if there's an open field, stuff like that.
Sure, yeah. You obviously don't just stroll through the daisies. You make an effort to be close to cover if need be, sure. You guys are making your way back, and I need you to give me a perception check. So front page of your character sheet, roll perception. Look at you. You hear a sort of whistle coming through the air, and then you hear this crack, and then the tree just a distance ahead of you. It's dark, so you can't see, but you can hear it coming down. What do you do?
I heard Golgotha laughing. Is this going to be a 2 years down the drain moment?
No.
That depends.
Okay,
do you dodge left or right? That's going to be an important answer.
Okay, does it crash into like an explosion, or just crashes? It's like taking down a tree.
It's like taking down a tree in a forest, right? So it's making a lot of noise and it's coming down.
I want to turn to Sly and say, should we check it out?
Sly's like, I guess. And he's kind of looking back to the cover. He's looking in the direction of the sound.
Okay, let's.
I didn't see a flash, he says.
Yeah, neither did I. Okay, well, let's slowly move over there.
All right. Prowl checks.
To get over there, we'll prowl. Yeah.
Yeah.
I failed.
All right. And you guys are making your way the best you can. Portland, I need you to give me a perception check.
Sure.
As you're busy rooting through. Yeah, you're distracted by pulling stuff off of the guy and looking for that that helmet. Lex, give me a olfactory smell check.
Olfactory. Hey.
All right. And you roll there. Cool. You do smell a human ahead of you, and you sense magic being used dead ahead.
Do I smell that it might be somebody that I've smelled before?
Yeah, or you can check to see if the magic is magic you've smelled before. Your choice.
Okay, would that be sent psychic and magic energy?
Yeah, so if we take a look at your list, right, you got recognize psychic scent.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So that's you recognizing a particular person's psychic scent.
Yeah.
And, right, and you've got...
That would be a specific.
That's right. Yeah.
I can try it.
Now, you've smelled it before, so I think there's a bonus for that. One sec. That's okay. Yeah, not that big of a bonus.
Even a bonus wouldn't get me there.
But you can also recognize the scent from olfactory as well. You have that there, so... Right, track by superior sense of smell specific is what you're rolling under there.
Yeah.
Nope.
Still no.
All right, so there's somebody using magic, and there's a human that you can smell, but you would have to roll to see if you can track it to its source.
Well, I know something's there, human magic user. I'm going to pull out my iron pulse rifle.
All right.
I'm going to get that sucker ready.
Yeah.
And start moving in.
All right. Sly's like, there's somebody using magic. That doesn't feel like the coalition to me.
I can smell it too. But it's only us and coalition out here, so who else could it be?
It's me!
Sly's like, well, I do know one magic user who's out here, but he should be with the rest.
Who would that be?
Portland, the guy that came with us. He says,
yeah, but he stayed at the hotel, didn't he?
Well, yeah, when we left him. Last time I checked, he had legs.
Let's just move with caution. I'm keeping my gun out.
Yeah. And so you guys move forward, and you see somebody's ass sticking up in the air, rooting around through the underbrush. And, Portland, you hear the crackling of twigs behind you.
Give him the normal dog greeting.
Just start jumping
them. Wow. Oh my god. That's just terrible.
This has devolved.
Yeah, now it's devolved.
Yeah.
So, as I come up behind them,
do I hear them?
Can I tell that it's something looks like Portland?
You also smell the scent of blood on the air now as you get closer. It's dark.
Can I turn around?
Yeah, for sure. You hear the crack of the twigs behind you. Yeah.
I'm like, hey,
stand up and turn around. Yep. And you see two figures, shadowy figures, stepping out of the brush. Lex, you recognize that same yellow poncho that Portland was wearing before on the boat.
Did someone order some armor? I'm just going to lift it up with a smile.
So I want to put my gun down and just be like, oh shit, how did you get out here?
It's a story.
You got armor? Like, what kind of armor?
This used to be dog.
Got a helmet?
Yep, right here.
Looks like he took care of our stray, says Sly.
I want to try it on. Does the helmet fit?
Yeah, it's similar to the armor with the helmet that you have. Like, it's one of those dog boy helmets. It's not a full face helmet.
Sweet.
Yeah, it is sweet. I'm going to keep this
saber. Got any Psy Stalker armor there?
Unfortunately, it didn't unfortunately run into me. This spider only caught one prey.
Shit. Because we need some Psy Stalker armor for Sly here.
Well, you can use me as bait if you really want to. As long as you come, save me before it sucks me off.
What's the plan for you guys?
For the other people that were with us?
Well, yeah, like, where are they? Are they with you, or what are they doing?
They are back at the hotel. There was a situation.
What's the situation?
Oh, I need to leave. What are they called? The Coalition? They're in the area, so I need to leave before they sniff me out. Thing sniffed me out apparently. Yeah. So then this used-to-be dog boy also smelled me and then stuck me up, so I decided to end its life.
Well, I don't know who's going to be smelling you. We took out a dog back. Although we didn't run into the Psy Stalker, did you see a guy with a spiky helmet among them?
I didn't see anyone besides this. I was just walking into the forest to get away from the situation in the town.
No, I mean in the town where the Coalition was. Did you see somebody with a spiky helmet?
I did see some people. I'm pretty sure I saw someone with a spiky helmet in there, yeah. I also have this radio.
Yeah, well, hold on to that.
Yeah.
So here's sorry for our the plan, blood Portland.
There, Lex. My apologies.
Yeah. It happens. I think this is the one guy that was chasing me down, and then he got away from me.
We deserve that.
So Sly and I are headed towards that weapons cache.
Okay.
And if we didn't find a Psy Stalker on the way, our plan is that Sly is going in as one of my prisoners.
Okay.
If we do find that weapons cache. If we do find that cache, Sly will throw on... Or if we do find a Psy Stalker along the way, Sly's going to throw on some armor. And we'll just try and get in that way as two Coalition soldiers. Maybe we could take you as our prisoner.
That's definitely a plan. I have no plans, so it sounds like a quote-unquote good plan. Because it isn't necessarily a bad plan. And yeah, I'm totally game for it.
Well, that's good, says Sly, because Lex could take us both in as prisoners, I guess, if I can't end up passing for Coalition.
Fair enough.
Look at me, I'm 4 feet tall. How would I get the two of you guys?
Well, you have a big gun, like this one. I lift it to him. Huh? And I have no guns.
No, it's just a little laser pistol that you're lifting to him, but...
No, well, you said you had another gun, much the pistol.
I have my iron pulse rifle in.
No, I thought the dog boy had another weapon.
He's got a C-18 knife, laser pistol, a vibro saber, and an SDC submachine gun.
Oh, sorry. I thought
he also has a fragmentation grenade. So.
Right, the grenade. Yeah, some cool shit here, guys. But yeah, I'm totally game. I'm probably more convincing as a captive than you are there, Sly. Because I'm a magic user, and they probably can sniff me out, right? As that dog boy said.
They can sniff us out, too.
Okay. Never mind, then. Well,
I mean, there's no reason to think that any dog boy or Psy Stalker couldn't sniff out everybody back at our camp except old Jack.
Right. Okay. Fair enough. Hey, I'm down. I'm down to play. You set the pieces. You put the green. You know, done. We'll play.
Well, I think we got to go Psystalker hunting. That's what we got to do right now.
Well, I didn't see one come by. That may be really hard to come by. Maybe there's one close down to the base. Or use this radio. Maybe you can find someone who can come down.
I'm currently jamming the radios.
Oh, never mind.
But I can stop if you really want to try to radio somebody.
Well, I don't know. I'm just trying to think out loud. Like, I have no plan, but if we want to maybe lure someone into a trap and be ambushed, and it is a Psystalker, maybe that could work to our advantage. I'm just thinking out loud. What do you guys think?
Hey, whatever's going to get a Psystalker here fastest.
No, you want to get a Psystalker here? Or do you want to get a Psystalker to go somewhere else?
Well, how are we going to kill him?
I'm just saying, do we want to do it here? Or do we want to do it somewhere else?
I have no idea.
I mean, if we can find somewhere that the ground gives us an advantage, that may not happen right here.
You don't think so, in the forest? In the dark?
I'm thinking maybe somewhere that we have some high ground.
Sure, I guess. Whatever, I'm down. You lead the way there, Lex. I'm just coasting like a plastic bag on the breeze.
Well, what do you think, Sly? You've been at this more than I have.
Well, I think I should keep jamming the radio transmissions.
Let's do that, then.
And if most of the coalition's in the town, well, that means there's less at the depot.
Also true.
But who knows? Those UAR-1s will still be at the depot. And we might not do so well without the rest. Speaking of which, we're going to jump back to the town. Hello, fantastic. Golgi and Teku.
Hello.
All right. You guys are, again, in the bedroom, looking out the window, and you see, you see this kind of view out there. Let me just... There we go. Move some guys around here. And put that guy there. All right. You see those out and about in the streets. The guys that were on the Sky Cycles have the swooped leg helmets that basically kind of redirect air past them so they don't get sucked off the motorcycle as they fly by. The other two guys just have more rounded helmets. They're the traditional dead boy armor. What they look like, that's just the side profile. What they look like from the front is more like that.
So they're armored up then.
They look, yeah, they are armored up just like that. The armor's a sort of blue-black, and the eyes have a red glow to them. So they are, it's designed to be intimidating. So that's what standard issue coalition armor is, known as dead boy armor. And coalition troops are typically known as dead boys because of the skull motif. So, these two guys are out in the street. They are investigating the, along with the unarmored coalition men that were at the other bar. They are still investigating the scene of the crime, I guess we can call. And they're there. The cycles are parked out. The two guys with the backpacks, though, they are walking toward your boarding house after they spoke to some individuals who pointed in that direction. And as they get about halfway across the street, a third grunt flies in with a jetpack and lands in front of them. And they converse for a few moments there.
I think we're going to miss his company. Bennett, maybe we should leave.
I don't know that that's a great move. Jack, go back to your room.
Why do you want me to go back to my room?
because they don't know you're involved. They know we're involved.
But they saw me come into town with you guys.
Yeah, that's true.
All right, well,
that old lady downstairs is going to rat me out just like she's going to rat you two out.
Oh, hell, maybe we should go out to them, just talk to them immediately.
Maybe we shouldn't go out.
No. Yeah.
Just take a look at what's standing out there.
It might be time to go.
No. You think you can wear those? He kind of nudges his nose up as he looks out at the three standing out there talking.
I mean, wearing it's one thing. Getting it off them is another.
Really? I seem to remember that you have some fancy tricks you can pull there, Mr. Sennett.
Yeah, and there's still five of them, not counting the other ones.
The other two are busy looking. Those three, and then you look out, and you can see the three of them are continue their journey toward the boarding house. They look like they're coming here.
Worth a shot.
I mean, we can try it, but I still think discretion's the better part of valor right now.
What can you do?
I think discretion has been flown out the window at this point.
Yeah, we'll deal with discretion later, he says. What can you do, Senate? No time to be...
I can disconnect their brains from their bodies. I can make it so that they're less likely to spot us, but that's only... It's not really applicable here. I mean, I could start tossing them around, but in that kind of armor, it's only going to do so much.
Disconnecting brain from body sounds like it might be effective.
Yeah.
That's one at a time, and that's if it works.
How long does that last?
Oh, it'll last a while. Long enough for us, anyway.
Well, if you can take one down right away, Luke and I can grab another one each. And then you just move along and take him out.
All right. We'll see how this goes. But I am leery. I guess we're stuck. The trick is to try and make sure they don't get a call out.
How quickly can we armor up before this happens?
I don't think we have time for that.
No, probably not.
Well, you and I, Luke, we could probably throw a dead boy armor on and a... About a minute.
Yeah, might take Senate my armor.
Might take Senate a little longer.
No, I'm just talking about my armor. If I have to, you know, pull them, you know, if I need to wrestle them and hold them.
Oh, I see. Well, probably about a minute, but I don't think we have that time.
No, that's fine.
You can make a shield, though, can you not?
I can.
That might be worth it. The sword's a bit extreme for now, but the shield, if nothing else, can be used.
Well, here they come, and you can hear thunk, thunk, thunk as they climb the steps of the front porch there.
Yep.
And then, dunk, 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 you can hear them knocking down below.
Well, we've got a couple of different rooms to work with. We can try and surprise them. I might stay here if you guys want to make yourself scarce in one of the other rooms. Leave this one cracked so they can see me.
All right.
Sure.
Let's vacate, Luke.
Yeah, and I look over him, nod, and we'll walk maybe to the room across.
Sounds good. Do you want to prowl?
And at this point, I don't think it means much right now.
Well, they might hear the creaking on the floor, so old Jack's...
That's fair. Yeah, I'll prowl. Let's see. That's under skills. And where's my prowl? My prowl is here. Ah, fuck. My prowl sucks. No, it doesn't suck, but it's not.
You're a metric ton.
Well, yeah, don't fat shame me.
Old Jack makes his way across.
I did. Oh my god, I barely. How come I'm barely failing everything?
What's your.
Because you suck.
50. I do suck.
Wow.
I got that earlier. Don't worry. I got that earlier. And how it feels.
Back to box. That's great.
Man, the boxes. The fucking boxes.
All right, so you guys, old Jack
tall wearing 30-pound crocs. Womp, womp,
womp. Old Jack steps deftly across the hall, opens the door quietly, and moves in. You move quietly across until you kind of get at the threshold of the door, then your weight causes the floorboard to go as you step in. And, yeah, if you guys give me a perception check each. All right. So,
did I roll?
You did, yep. Got a 15.
Okay.
Sir Luke, as you sit there cringing and you make your way into the room, you can hear very stormtrooper-like kind of speaking through a helmet is what these guys will sound like, right? Good evening, ma'am.
Oh, thank God, right. They're going to have terrible aim.
Good evening, ma'am, one of them says, and you can hear the woman saying, oh, well, Senate, you don't hear this. You've put the door ajar and stepped back or beside or whatever, but you can't make out the conversation. But Luke can. And, yeah. Oh, I'm glad you're here, she says. I think we've got ourselves a problem. We'll check it out. Come on, boys. And just stand aside, ma'am. And you can begin to all be sent it. You definitely hear the clomping of them moving up the stairs.
Yep. And I will take an otherwise defiant position in the room.
Okay. Cool. They head up the stairway there. Old Jack, want to close the door, Luke?
Yep, I'll close it.
Okay. And give me another prowl check. Try to redeem yourself.
Oh, I feel this is going to go poorly.
Hand goes through door.
It very well.
He just slams it.
I am not subtle. All right, here you go. Just a second here. Where's my prowl? Here you go. All right. No whammies, no whammies, no whammies, no whammies.
Nice and soft.
There we go. There we go.
Nice and soft. You just, you know, you slowly turn the doorknob so that it doesn't even click when it locks, or latches, rather. And you can hear the clomping of feet coming up steps, heavy boots. You can hear them, Luke, going past the door and stopping, because you guys went across the hall from Senate's door.
Yep.
Right, you can hear dunk dunk on the door across the hall. Senate, you hear them knock on that door.
Wait, on my door? Or
yeah, on your door. Yeah.
Yeah, I left it ajar.
That's right. They still give a knock on it.
Yeah. Okay. And I'll turn around and what?
Okay, you say as the force of them knocking on it pushes the door open. You see these three guys. I'm going to hide the Sky Cycle pilots because they're not really.
We hope they're not relevant.
They're not in the building anyway.
Yet.
And yeah, so essentially the arrangement of guys to you, I'm going to shift the action to the center of the screen here, is kind of like this, with you in the room, and the one grunt stands at the door. And the other two kind of flank him, but not fully visible, because obviously the door is only one man wide, but they stand in the hall. They all have their rifles out, and the door swings open, and you're there, and you say...
Is this about the bar?
Yeah.
You may as well come in, and I'll go and sit on the bed. Looking non-threatening.
Just stand where you are. Put your hands in the air.
And I'll mid-turn heading toward the bed and say, you know, I'm unarmed. I don't know what exactly you're looking for here.
We want to keep it that way. Right? And he
Tell
steps.
Me you're wearing pants. Are you wearing pants? I'm just curious.
Yeah. So the first guy steps in. Cool. What do the other two do?
They stand in the hall.
Oh, of course they do.
And they all have their laser rifles, right? Mm-hmm. And where's your friend, the tall one?
I think he went over to the outhouse.
Lady downstairs says you're all up here, all cozy.
Well, I came up here. He came up here. Where he went after that is anyone's sort of affairs.
Mm-hmm. Keep your hands up. Put them on your head. Turn around.
I'll put my hands up, and as I do, I'll say, your friend in the back isn't looking too well there. And then I will attempt to use biomanipulation on the guy right in front of me.
I thought, on the guy right in front of you?
Yeah, shouting one thing and doing another seems appropriate, just to further confuse the situation.
Yeah.
And I will shoot for paralysis.
All right.
While again, seemingly putting my hands up and complying. So that's a 10 ISP. And I don't know what his saves look like.
No, you don't. But I do. Let's just do initiative check real quick.
Oh, sure.
That's a lot of dice.
Has danger sense kicked off at all?
Yeah, you would have your danger sense for sure.
Okay.
Probably, it probably kicked off the minute these guys kind of knocked on the door downstairs. Yeah.
Really should move that to the top of my list so it's easier to find. Sixth sense, not danger sense.
Yeah, so take off an additional 2 ISP for that.
Yeah, so that's a plus 6 to initiative.
Yeah, plus your usual. Sure, yeah, and make sure you select your token. Be helpful here.
Yep. Initiative 6. I started like yesterday. Oh, damn, that one guy's quick.
Yeah, but you get to go.
Spread across all of them. Yeah, okay.
Yeah, it's all written in the turn order there. You get to go first.
Two more. Yep, so.
So, biomanipulation.
Yeah, biomanipulation, turn off body.
And you're doing grunt one, the guy right in front of you?
Yeah, he's got the gun right in front of me. The other two should be taken relatively unawares.
All right, well. He fails, and he drops to the ground.
Let me just see how long this lasts for.
I think it's 4d4 minutes.
Okay, so let's roll 4d4. That's not a lot of minutes, but it should be enough.
Or so 7 minutes, that's pretty good.
Oh, it's above. Sorry, I was going through the text. Yeah, okay, yep.
Cool. He's out for 7 minutes. He collapses to the ground. Grunt one. You say that your buddy doesn't look so good back there. That guy drops, and grunt one. He levels.
As he drops, I'll kind of flinch like I'm surprised by the whole thing.
Okay, he levels his gun at you and says, hands on your head, turn around! And the other grunt moves into the room. And basically tries turning you. Trying to grab you and kind of push you down. Spun around and pushed down.
It seems like a time we should come in at this point to be a distraction.
You certainly can. With a 5, he'll have a plus 2, so it's a 7. So he will be able to basically lay hands on you unless you do something, Senate.
Well, I don't see the two big guys yet, so that's probably... It's best to go along with it for now, given the rifle aimed at me.
Okay. Cool. So you don't resist, and he basically
I'll just kind of be shouting like, "What's wrong with your?"
So he's got his rifle in one hand, and he basically kind of grabs your grabs you and spins you around, sort of thing, turning you to face away. This is the beginning of the second attack, basically, is what's going on here. That brings us back to the top to Senate. You guys can, you and old Jack can enter the next round, right? So it'll be, you know, only 15 seconds will go by after these guys are done with their attacks. So, so your second attack, Senate.
So both of them have rifles aimed at me, right?
No, only one of them, because the other one stepped in. He has his rifle in his hand, his one hand, but he reached out and grabbed you to turn you around. The other guy is laying on the ground. So only the grunt, only grunt three has his rifle trained on you.
Okay. So as he's spinning me around, I might look back at the guy on the ground and say, what's going on with your friend? And as I say that, I'm going to look over at grunt three and see if I can hit him.
Okay. For sure. Yeah, you kind of turn back around.
Yeah. Even if I just catch him in the reflection of the window I was just looking out of, that'd be also kind of helpful.
Yeah, we'll say you definitely turn and look at Grunt 3. Mm-hmm. He will make a roll to save. And he drops.
It's 10 more ISP.
And I'm rolling the duration for him here. For 9 minutes. And Grunt 2 says, "Ah, shit!" And he points his rifle at you, and he will shoot.
Ooh,
he will shoot.
Yeah,
this sixth sense is going to come in real handy, I think.
So he rolls his to just shoot at you. He's real close. Mm-hmm. And he misses, probably because you are in a he was basically I would say it's also penalized by a minus six, so that would have been a zero, because he was just kind of doing a melee sort of action, so he just like picked up his rifle, pointed it in your direction and shot, but he missed. It doesn't quite put the hole through the wall you thought it would, but it does leave a burn mark on the wall. And back to you there, Senate. Your third attack.
Yeah. I'm gonna kind of... I assume I sort of ducked precognitively, got out of the way. I'll turn.
Yeah, you probably flinched a little bit, yeah?
Yeah. And then I'll try and take him out as well, because apparently it's just the Senate show today.
And that it is.
Well, night-night.
Ten minutes.
Yes, indeed.
This one I'll before he hits the ground, I'll catch so that he's...
No, he just drops. You're too busy concentrating, so...
Oh, okay.
Fair. He just clunk, drops as well. And yeah, that's the end of that combat and round. Sir Luke, you and old Jack bust out of the room and see three unconscious... Well, not necessarily immobile... Immobile.
Yeah, I'm holding my finger to my lips, just like... Loud is not our friend right now.
Old Jack grabs one and drags him into the room.
Yep. I'll do the other one. Actually, I'll do two.
No, one's right in front of Senate, so you...
Oh, okay.
I'm going to stick my head out the window real quick and try and assess whether or not any of the remaining coalition forces noticed the gunshot.
It's not a blast, right? It doesn't make a sound. It's a laser, so.
But again, I'm just curious.
Yeah, there doesn't seem to be any any attention. They're really focused on the bar right now.
Okay.
And
quick question though. We know stormtroopers are clones, so they're all the same size, except for Luke. You know, will the armor fit me?
How tall are you again?
6'9".
I don't think so, dude.
So the average height in Rift's Earth for North American men is 6 feet. So the tall ones seem to survive, I guess, the cataclysm. So that means, and you're 6'9", you said?
Yeah.
Yeah, you're really tall. It probably is, you would probably not be in standard armor. So this probably won't fit you very well. But
you
Senate,
are big enough to make a good prisoner.
Yeah, you that's are. What I was thinking.
Yeah, for sure.
But we're still going to strip the guy of the armor anyways.
Yeah.
And this will only last so long. If we don't want them running out of here in their street clothes, we probably need a bit more of a long-term solution.
Well, we tie them up.
Put them in the closet, says old Jack.
Yep.
Fair enough. And I'm going to start, again, still real suspicious of everything happening out on the street, and then start taking the armor off this guy.
Yep, so you guys strip them of their armor. They are all conscious. Their eyes are open. They cannot move. They have a look of fear on their face as you guys begin to strip them of their armor and jetpacks and weapons. These guys have some interesting gear, in the sense that they have these jetpacks, which I don't think any of you really know how to use. But they have their body armor, C-12 laser rifle, C-18 laser pistol, SDC submachine gun, vibro knife, 2 frag grenades, and their jetpacks.
That's a lot of stuff. I like the grenades, to be told. Like, truth be told, I can do a lot with them if given the opportunity.
Mm-hmm.
But I am rather leery of the jetpacks. But you know what? It'll suit the scene to wear it, so we'll wear it. And I'll look at Sir Luke and say, again, they're going to be like this for a couple of minutes. We have time. I assume we have bed sheets we can rip up and make bindings. And
already started. Already started.
He says, leave those sheets alone. Says, we don't need them looking for people with, you know, tied up in sheets. Here, we'll use these. And he basically pulls out some zip ties.
Well, that's even better.
Okay.
Take their socks and stuff them in their mouths.
You were going to start pulling out ball gags or something next.
Yeah, that's...
No judgments.
I was kind of judgment, honestly. No,
Dude rolls up with 2 metal arms and at least 3 ball gags. I'm not asking any further questions. Zip ties notwithstanding. This guy came to party. I like him.
Okay, so yes, I am going to as we strip these guys, I'm going to, you know, tie them up very, very tightly. Do the ball, ball gag. The sock. See what you did? Got that in my brain now. Yeah, so you'll stuff the sock down the throat.
Bit of a moment of awakening for Golga on that one.
So shove in the closet.
All right, so old Jack and Senate, you guys change into coalition armor.
Mm-hmm.
All right, and Sir Luke, you are not.
Prisoner.
And you guys have. What are you doing with the third suit of armor?
Do you want to wear part of your armor? So that it looks like we caught you mid-change, which would make it easier to put the rest of it on, if needed, on short notice.
Yeah, because I want to take my armor with me, because we'll need it.
So it's probably worth starting that process, too.
Yeah, done. Easy. I'm quick.
And if you've got a backpack or a rucksack of some kind, we'll throw the rest of your armor in there and carry it with us.
Yep.
What are you doing with the coalition armor?
probably not ideal to bring it with us.
So what are you doing with it?
That's a great question. I don't know. And I'll kind of look over at Jack and be like, "Do you? Are we hiding it somewhere? Are we stashing it somewhere? It's not coming with us.
Can we destroy it?
Don't destroy it. Why don't we set it out on the roof?
Yeah.
Yep, good idea.
Actually, that's not a terrible idea either. I also have an idea for dealing with the old woman.
Yeah, what's that?
That's if it comes to it.
We need to deal with her. She's going to talk.
We might be able to just say, hey, we caught this one upstairs. Our sergeant's upstairs holding the third one. We're waiting for extraction. Stand clear. Do not go up there. Keep everyone else from going up there. It'll buy us the time we need to get out of here. Unless, of course, you want to gag her and throw her in the closet, too.
I think we're going to have to do that.
Yeah, I think so as well.
Oh, well, in that case, we probably don't need my mind tricks. Given that we have the armor, we can just ask her to come upstairs and then...
I'm on it. He puts the helmet on. He puts the helmet on, heads downstairs. You can hear, ma'am, we need to talk to you upstairs. Oh, okay. She comes upstairs, and basically, when she comes in and sees you two standing there, he grabs her from behind, sleeper hold, and she's in another closet with her own, I don't know, socks in her mouth and zip-tied.
Take that, racist.
You're welcome.
All right.
Speciesist? Human supremacist, whatever.
All right. And with that, you guys have some Coalition armor. Lex has some armor. Portland and Sly there. We're pulling the classic, fake prisoner trick. And
I'm basically Chewbacca, so there you go.
That's right. Yeah, all hairy and everything.
I have set Lex up to be Chewbacca. You are a young Vader. Don't worry about it. We'll get there.
Wait, no.
It's fine. We're getting there.
All right. So with that,
don't question it.
With that, thank you guys for tuning in yet again for this episode. Again, if you like what you heard, hit the subscribe. Want notifications, hit the bell. We would love to hear from you. Put the comments down below. Join us on our Discord. Tell your friends. We're going to be playing Rifts for a little while still. And I'm Magnum Pie here with Teku, Golgotha, Vahilo, and Dark Templar, and we are Initiative Zero.